Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and on today's video, we're going to be running one ton of ore through our one ton per hour turnkey system here behind me. We're going to run it through the jaw crusher, the hammer mill, and then onto the shaker table for final concentration of the gold. And then after the shaker table, we'll take our concentrates and we'll take them over and we'll refine them into our final gold buttons. But let's get started here running our material and we'll see how much gold we can recover. We sell three different sizes of turnkey systems, a 1 ton per hour, a 2 ton per hour, and a 4 to 5 ton per hour system. Also, we have an option for a ball mill or a hammer mill, depending on your grind size and kind of what your project is and what it entails. Okay guys, we've cleaned up the shaker table, finished running our one sack or one ton of ore. We have our number one high grade concentrates, as well as our number two high grade concentrates. And so I'm gonna do something a little bit different. Rather than smelting these, I'm gonna try doing a little bit quicker method where I'm just gonna pan down the number one clean up the gold as best I can, and then straight cupel it with lead. And that way we don't have to smelt it, screw around, waste a bunch of time and energy. We can just cupel it directly, clean it up, get our gold button. Well, we're going to recover 95%+ of the gold out of these number one and number two concentrates. And then the panning tailings, I can just rerun back through the system, so I'm not spending a bunch of time screwing around, smelting, and for half a gram or 1 gram of gold. We can just recycle it and keep running our equipment. So that's the plan. Let's get panning here. We'll see how much gold we have in our number one. Now we got to be pretty careful when we're panning down the concentrates, because that's where all our gold is, and it's really quite fine. But I'm thinking in 5 or 10 minutes here, I can have this pan down pretty much to pure gold, and we'll take a look and clean up the gold out of there. But you can see all the gold right along the back edge here. So there's a significant amount of gold in this pan. We've got our gold pan down. This is our number one concentrates, and there's quite a bit of depth there as well. So there's some pretty good gold there. But now this is clean enough. I'm going to suck it up with a pipette and put it in a little paper towel and get it kind of dry. And then we can put it in our cupel with a little bit of lead and run it right in our electric furnace and recover our gold bead. All right, so I'm going to take our little snuffer bottle here and I'm going to suck up as much gold as we can and just run it down here like a coffee filter. Oh, the gold's clogged the tip there. There we go. And then our gold's in our little blue towel there. And then we're just going to wad that up and put it in our cupel and put some lead on it. The paper will burn away and we'll be left with our gold button. So I'm just going to work down this pan here a little bit, get as much gold out as we can. I'll have to redo it probably 2 or 3 times. And then we'll take a look at our towel and we're done. All right, here's our rag. And there's our little gold, our fine gold blob down there. I've wrung out the water. So it's actually really similar to how they do it with mercury. But I'm not using any mercury. I've just wrung out the water. And now I'm going to wad it up in a little wad and cut off the ball at the end and put it in a cupel, put a little lead on it, put it in the furnace, and we should have our gold button. Okay, here's our cupel here. It's a little bit warm. I just warmed it up in the furnace a little bit. It's probably 300 or 400 degrees. I'm going to take our little sack of gold, I guess. We'll put it in there. I'm going to put it back in the furnace and let that dry out and burn off. And then I'm going to add, this is about 12 grams of lead. I'll just put that on top of the ash when it's all burned off and melt the lead and cupel away the lead. Oxidize it, run it into the cupel, and then we'll be left with our gold button, gold and silver. All right, it's probably hard to see, but right in there's our little sack, and it's drying out. It's actually starting to burn a little bit, starting to smoke. And hopefully as that gold dries and the thing burns, I don't just splatter gold all over the inside of here, of the furnace. All right, we got the gold from number one in the furnace, so now let's work on the number two high grade. I'll get this pan down and see how much gold we have in here. All right, guys, well, here's the results from number two. And let's see if I can get a focus here. There's hardly any gold in there at all. So it was a good check. I'm glad I did it and panned it down, but in the future, I'm not going to waste the time. I'm just going to put the number two and the number three right back through the mill and only screw around with the number one. And we'll just keep upgrading them, and we don't have to screw around smelting them, panning them, anything else. But I'll suck this out of here, put it in a cupel, get it in the furnace, and see exactly how much gold we have. But I'm guessing 95% of the gold ended up in the number one high grade. All right, there's our little bit of gold from the number two, and I just put it right into the cupel with the pipette, so it's a little bit wet. I'm going to put it in the furnace with about 10 grams of lead. I'm going to put another cupel right on top of it upside down, so as that dries out, it might spit a little bit or pop.
And the cupel on top will shield it from spitting all over the furnace. We can still recover our little gold beads from the spitting and popping. So we'll get that in the furnace next to the number one and see how much gold we got. And here's our panning tailings from the number one and the number two. And I know what you guys are gonna say. I absolutely did lose some gold, I'm quite sure, when I panned out our material. So we didn't get 100% recovery, but there's probably less than half a gram of gold in here, and hopefully quite a bit less. So it's not worth the time and effort to go after it by trying to smelt it all down or refine it or, you know, worry about it. So we've got 95% of our gold out. It's in the furnace, it's cupelling. This stuff is just gonna go right back through the system. We'll recover whatever little bit of residual gold I lost from panning on the table, and it'll go into the number one or number two, and then we can try again to recover it on our next go around. But that's the important thing on this video I wanna get across is when you're sampling and trying to find out the best recovery of your gold, it's really important to get all of it so you can get your percent recoveries. But when you're in production, every hour counts, especially if you have a short season and you don't want to be screwing around for hours or days up at the site trying to refine every last little bit of your gold. You want to get your throughput, get your concentrates, get the gold out, and for the cash flow so you can keep your operation going. If you want to, you could even save this in a barrel and then bring it down at the end of the season or at a later time and process it then. But you really don't want to spend all your time and energy when you're on site trying to recover every last little bit of gold. All right, guys, so I want to try something a little bit unique. I don't think I've ever seen or heard anybody doing this before. Here's our gold button. Let's see if we can get the focus there. There we go. And you can see it's not gold. It's froze because there's too much base metals in there, and it's got a skin of oxides that are above the melting point of our furnace, so they've just formed a skin and froze the bead. So what I'm gonna try is adding just a little bit of borax to it. I need to keep the button exposed on the surface, but if I get a little bit of borax on there, you see what happens? Look at that. Almost instantly pulled those oxides off the surface, absorbed them into the borax, and turned it gold. Okay, here's our two beads, the number one and the number two. All right, number one is 20.23. Had to go up to a bigger scale that goes past 20 grams. And the number two is 0.76 grams. When you put them all together, you get 21 grams even. It's not too bad.
All right, guys, so what'd you think of the video? We recovered 21 grams of gold in a little under 2 hours. It took me about an hour and 10 minutes to run the one ton of material. It took me about 10 minutes to pan it out. It took me about 10 minutes to get it cleaned up and in the furnace. And then it took me about half an hour, a little bit less, to cupel it and recover the gold bead from the lead. But I hope you guys can see the difference between my strategy on production versus sampling. When you're sampling and you want to figure out, you know, your percent recovery and how much gold you have, it's really important to get it all, and the timing isn't really a concern at that point. But when you're in production and you only have a very limited amount of time on site or your season's really short, every hour counts. And as you can see, if I ended up spending an hour cleaning all that stuff up, it's an hour that I could have spent getting another 21 grams of gold through the system. And so if I had a pile of gold ore sitting around like that, it'd be costing me about $1,000 an hour every hour I wasn't running material through the system. The other point, though, is you have to recover your gold and sell it and get paid. You need that cash flow. So you have to process the gold as fast as you can so that you can get your money, pay for your equipment, pay your employees, whatever you need to do. So, but you need to make it as fast and as efficient as possible. If you guys have any questions about the equipment you saw today, you can find more information on our website, or you can give us a call or send us an email, and you can find our contact information in the description below. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.